Yes, so dear student, I Rakesh Jain from Gyanvihar University. Today I am going to teach you about the resistor's basic law, that is Ohm's law, and what is the meaning of resistivity. First of all, what is the meaning of Ohm's law? We know that resistor is a device which provide obstacle in the flow of current. Resistor is a device which provide obstacle in the flow of current. So whenever some voltage is applied across the resistor's two terminal, then some current will be flow through it. The Ohm's law state that whenever current passes through a resistor, then the voltage across the resistor will be proportional to the value of that current. So V is proportional to I. And we know that whenever proportional sign we just remove and just put an equal to sign, then some constant will be placed there. So the constant is denoted as R, and that is known as resistor. So V is proportional to I. That means V is equal to IR, where the meaning of R is resistor. We can also say that resistor is equal to the voltage divided by the current. Okay. So we will see how the Ohm's law will be applicable to any numerical. So that is known as Ohm's law. And the second thing is, resistor can also be denoted in terms of its length and cross-sectional area A. So in terms of that, we can say resistor is a device which is proportional to the length, whose resistance is proportional to the length, and the value of that resistance is inversely proportional to the cross-sectional area A. So we can say R is proportional to L, and second thing, R is proportional to 1 by A. When we just merge these two terms, R is proportional to L by A. So when we remove that proportional sign, R is equal to rho L by A, where the meaning of rho is resistivity. Okay, now see this MS Paint file on which whatever I taught you till now, I am going to write down there, and we will do certain numerical on the basis of that explanation. So let's begin. So our topic is, first of all, the Ohm's law. First topic is Ohm's law. So what is the meaning of this Ohm's law? Ohm's law state that the voltage across a resistance is proportional to the current passing through the resistor. What is the Ohm's law? Now see, what is Ohm's law? Ohm's law state that Ohm's law state that the voltage across the resistor is proportional to the current passing through it. Once again, I am telling you, what is the meaning of Ohm's law? Ohm's law is a law which is state that, let's suppose you have a resistor R. This is a symbol of resistor, as we know. This is a symbol of resistor. Okay. Which is denoted by R, so I just write down R. So Ohm law state that voltage is actually abbreviated or denoted by V. So the voltage across the resistance V is always proportional to the current I passes through the resistance. Let's suppose due to this voltage, the current I is passing from this resistance R. So Ohm's law state that the voltage is proportional to the current I. Whenever we remove the proportional sign, we know that some constant will be there, and this constant is actually your R. So that is resistance, the value of that resistor. Okay, so this is known as Ohm's law. Once again, I am repeating, Ohm's law state that whenever, let's suppose you have a resistor, you just applied a voltage across the two terminal of that resistor. So some current will be passes through it. So Ohm's law state that the voltage which you applied across the resistor is directly proportional to the current passes through the resistor. So is V is proportional to I. So V is equal to I multiplied by the value of that resistor, that is resistance R. So V is equal to I R. Now remember about this current, whenever the resistance are in series, for example, let's suppose you have two resistor. Let's suppose these are two resistor, one is R1 and second one is R2. One is R1, then second one is R2. Let's suppose you have two resistance, one is R1 and second one is R2. Then remember one thing, you know that whenever resistors are in series, they will be add up to each other. Now I am not telling about the resistance series and parallel combination. I am teaching you right now about the current relation with the series value of resistance. So what I want to say, so whenever resistances are in series, then the current will be equally flow through it. So what I want to say, this R1 and R2 resistance are in series. So if I say that the current from this R1 resistance is, let's suppose Ix, if I say the current through this R1 resistance is, let's suppose Ix, then what is the current through this R2 resistance? So remember the rule, whenever resistances are in series, then current is always equal. Whenever resistances are in series, then current is always equal. So if the current passes through this R1 resistor is Ix, then what is the current passes through this R2 resistance? Because both are in series, so definitely the same current Ix will be passes through this resistance also. So similarly, the same current, whatever passes through R1, will be also passes through the R2. Okay, this is not a part of this Ohm's law, but I just taught you because I want that you should know about everything about the resistor, so that whenever we will complete the topic, you should know about the color coding method, the series parallel, the numerical approach, the rules behind all the resistances. So that's why. So remember this, keep in your mind that whenever resistor are in series, then equal current will be flow through there. Okay. And what is the Ohm's law? If you have a resistor, you just applied a voltage across the two terminal of that resistor, then whatever the current passes through that resistor should be equal to the applied voltage. So V is proportional to I, and V is equal to IR, where the value of or the meaning of R is the value of that resistor. That is resistance. Okay. Now the second thing which I want to teach you right now is that resistivity. I want to teach you about the resistivity. Wait, what is the meaning of resistivity? Actually, this value of resistor, actually the value of resistor, that is known as resistance. So resistance is always proportional to the length. Resistance is always proportional to the length, and resistance is always proportional to its inversely proportional to its cross sectional area. Resistance is inversely proportional to cross sectional area. Okay. Resistance is always proportional to the length of resistor. Resistance is inversely proportional to the cross-sectional area of the resistance. So these are two rules. Now whenever we just combine these two things, then what will happen? R is proportional to L, and R is proportional to 1 by A. It means R is proportional to L multiplied by 1 by A. So we can say R is proportional to L, and R is inversely proportional to 1 by A. That is, R is proportional to L by A. Okay. So whenever we just remove this proportional sign, then some constant should be there. And that constant now in this term is rho. It is pronounced as rho. It looks like a typical P. It looks like a tick of P, a letter P, but it is not actually P. P is like this one. P is like this one, we know. Okay. But this is not P. This is someone different from P. Yeah, like this one. This is not P. This is known as a row. Its pronunciation of this symbol is row, and the meaning of this row is resistivity. The meaning of this row is resistivity. What is this? This is your resistivity. This is your resistivity. Okay. And what is the unit of this resistivity? Ohm meter. If we put a resistance R as ohm, we know that resistance R unit is ohm. I just shift it a little bit, so I will teach you clearly. Okay, this is. Now I just shift it here. Now see, R is equal to rho L by A. So what is rho? So what is rho? Just see to find out the unit. What is rho? So rho is equal to this A will be multiplied by this R. This A we will be go here and multiply by this R. So R is multiplied by P divided by this L will be go here at the denominator side. So divided by L. So rho is equal to R multiplied by A by L. R multiplied by A by L. And we know that what is the, now we want to find out the unit of this resistivity. So now see. Okay, I remove this. Okay, R is equal to rho L. I just write down here. So rho, what is the unit of rho? So rho is equal to, we want to find out. What is the unit of this R? I just to show you with this blue color. What is the unit of this R? We know that the unit of this R is ohm multiply by A. A is area, and we know that area formula is length multiplied by width. So if length is in meter, width is in meter, then definitely it is meter square. So ohm meter square, okay? Divided by L. L is what? Length. Length is, if it is in meter, then meter. Okay. Now this meter to this square term will be cancel out. So now what is remaining? So the unit of this resistivity is ohm meter. Ohm meter, only ohm and meter is remaining. Okay, so what is the unit of this resistivity? Ohm meter. I just write down here unit of resistivity is ohm meter. Okay, now I just okay, so unit of resistivity is ohm meter. So what you understand till now, that the resistor, there is a basic fundamental formula behind the resistor use, that is Ohm's law. And Ohm's law state that whenever voltage applied across the two terminal of the resistance, then some current flow through it. The value of that current and the applied voltage is proportional to each other. So V is proportional to I. That is V is equal to IR, where the meaning of R is resistance. So this is V is equal to IR is known as Ohm's law. One more thing which I taught you is, whenever resistances are in series, then current is always equal. If by an example I taught you that if two resistances R1 and R2 are there and some current I passes through it, then if resistance or the current passes through R1 resistor is I1, IX for example, then what is the current passes through the R2 resistor? The same current IX, because they are in series. The second thing about the resistivity, if we talk about the resistor and we want to define the resistor in terms of its length and cross-sectional area, then we can say the value of the resistance is always proportional to its length L. That is, R is proportional to L. R is proportional to L. This one, I am talking about this one. I am repeating this one. R is proportional to L. And one more thing about this cross-sectional area, if resistance is R, then resistance is proportional to one, inversely proportional to 1 by A, inversely proportional to 1 by A. So when we just write down these two things together, then we can say R is proportional to L by A. R is proportional to L by A. Okay. So when we remove this proportional sign, then I will find R is equal to rho L by A. R is equal to rho L by A. So that rho value, that rho constant is known as resistivity, whose unit rho is equal to, it is not a pure constant because constant are unitless. We just put it, whenever we just remove a proportional sign, there should be some new thing. So that new thing is here rho. So rho is known as resistivity, whose unit is ohm meter. We just prove that its unit is ohm meter with the help of putting all the remaining parameters units. Resistance is ohm, area is, let's suppose, in meter square, and the length in meter. So meter to meter square is cancelled one time. So ohm meter is the unit of resistivity. Now I am going to teach you about some numericals related to the ohm's law and resistivity. Okay. So anyone student, just take a snapshot of this MS Paint file along with your names and just send it on my WhatsApp. Okay. Now I just save this file. Okay, now after this, I just want to show you the new thing, that is this one. Yes, the numericals which we want to do on this Ohm's law is, wait for a while. Yes, we want to do some numerical. Let's suppose we begin our journey with Ohm's law. Let us suppose we begin our journey with the Ohm's law. So this is a numerical for you. Wait for a while. Yes. I just take an example which I, yes, let's suppose I have this example, this one. Find the current I that is in front of you. Find the current I through a resistor of resistance R is equal to 2 ohm if the voltage across the resistor is 6 volt. Okay, it is a very simple numerical in front of you. Now, we know that voltage is always proportional to current multiplied by resistance because this is Ohm's law. Now, what is the voltage given? So, see, in this numerical, it is mentioned that the voltage across the resistor is 6 volt. The voltage across the resistor is 6 volt. It means V is equal to 6. It means V is equal to 6. It is given that V is equal to 6. Okay. So in place of V, I just write down 6. That is equal to I multiplied by R. Okay. So it is mentioned in the numerical that you have to find out the current I. It means current we have to find out. So in place of I just put I multiplied by R. So it is mentioned in the, it is given in the question that the value of the resistance is 2 ohm. It means R is equal to 2 ohm. Okay, so what is the current? It is very simple to find out the value of the current. 6 is equal to I multiplied by 2. It means I is equal to 6 divided by 2. So that is 3 ampere. So this is a very sweet and very simple numerical. And you see, with the help of Ohm's law, we just see this one. Remember one thing. Whatever we learn, whatever I teach you in this subject, in theory, whenever our lab will be there, either the topics are in the laboratory or not in the syllabus of the practicals. We have to do the 10 practicals. I will teach you all the 10 practicals, but not take a boundary to complete only those 10 practical. We see all those profs. We just take a battery of 6 volt. We just take a resistance of 2 ohm. Then we connect the multimeter and we will check that it will be 3 ampere. So that we prove that Ohm's law is valid. So that we will prove that Ohm's law is valid. So my answer will be 3 ampere, because this ampere is not A for the ampere. Ampere is the unit of current. Remember, ampere. P. So I is equal to 3 ampere. This is my answer of this question. A very simple question. We have to find out the current and we easily find out the current. Now we go for the second example. So just I remove this one. In recording, you see all this things. So now I see this one. Okay, now see, let's suppose I have a second numerical, which is this one. Just I copy this one first of all. Yes. Now see, this one is my second numerical. See very carefully. It is given in the question that in this circuit, two resistors are there, R1 and R2. Okay, they are in series. If it is not written that it is in series, but we know that these two resistors are in series because one point R1 and R2 is connected with each other. So two resistances are in series, and they have the resistance of 5 ohm and 6 ohm respectively. It means R1 is of 5 ohm and R2 is of 10 ohm. Okay, I just move this diagram here. Okay, you now see this one very clearly. So it is given that they are 5 ohm and 10 ohm. It means R1 is equal to of 5 ohm. Okay, and the value of R2 is 10 ohm. It is given in the question. It is given in the question. Okay, the voltage across resistor R1 is equal to 4 volt. The voltage across this resistor R1 is 4 volt. It is given that the voltage across this resistor is 4 volt. 4 volt across these two terminal of this resistor. Across means across the two terminal of the resistor. It is given that V is equal to 4. Okay. If it is not clear in front of you, I just remove one again this numeric 4 and one again write down very carefully this 4. Okay, so V is equal to 4 across the two terminal of the resistor, across the terminal of the resistor. Okay, so what is the current passing through the resistor R2? We have to find out what is the current passes through this resistor R2. So current is denoted by I. So I just write down I. What is the I through this resistor? I have to find out what is the I through this resistance. This is a sign of question mark, and if you don't understand, I just put it like this one. Okay. Okay. So what is the current passes through the resistor, and what is the voltage across the same resistor? And what is the voltage across this resistance? One more thing. What is the voltage across this resistance? I have to find. So two things we have to find out. Okay, nothing is given the next. Now, with the help of the Ohm's law, we will find out both the answers. Now see very carefully how we can easily find out the answer of this question. See, it is not given that what is this E, what is this voltage. So don't know what is given, just focus on that. What is given? A resistor is given whose value is 5 ohm. I am talking about this part. I am talking about this thing. A voltage V is given, that is, we know that what is Ohm's law? V is equal to IR. V is equal to IR. Okay. So now what is given? Voltage given as 4 volt. Voltage given across this R1 resistor as 4 volt. Okay, so that is equal to, current is not given. What is the current through this R1 5 ohm resistor? It is not given. So I just put it as I. Okay, then multiplied by R. So what is the resistance R value? Because it is 5 ohm, so resistance value is 5. Okay, so what is the current I can easily find out through this resistance? Because voltage is 4 and resistance is 5. It means what is the current? Current is 4 divided by 5. Okay. Current is 4 divided by 5. That is 0.8 ampere. When we divide 0.8 ampere. Okay. So I understand that the current passes through this R1 resistor is 0.8 ampere. 0.8 ampere. Okay, now I have to find out what is the current. I am talking about this one. I have to find out what is the current passes through this resistor. Okay, now see very carefully. and keep in your mind my words, which I have already been taught you few minutes ago, that whenever resistances are in series, whenever resistances, let's suppose this one is R1 resistor, this one is R2 resistor. Okay. Let's suppose this one is R1 resistor and this one is your R2 resistor. Okay. So whenever they are in series, if current passes through the first resistor is Ix, if current passes through the first resistor is Ix, then what is the current passes through the second resistor? The rule is whenever resistances are in series, equal current passes through both of them. So it means the current passes through the second resistor is also Ix. So similarly, here R1 and R2 are in series, and it is also mentioned in the question that R1 and R2 resistor is in series. Okay, so because they are in series, it means the second current is also of 0.8 ampere. No need to worry about. We directly find out that the second value of this current is also 0.8 ampere because both are in series. Because both are in series, no need to worry about that one. Okay, the second thing, when we find out the value of the current, what is the voltage? Now again we know that the Ohm's law state that V is equal to IR. Okay, so what is the voltage we have to find? So V is equal to, what is the current through this R2 resistor? That is 10 ohm resistance. So I just find out that current is 0.8 again. So 0.8 multiply by, what is the value of the resistance? This second resistance value is given as 10 ohm. So 0.8 multiply by 10, that is definitely 8 volt. So this is my complete answer of the question. This is my complete answer of the question. And the question asked me to find out two things. What is the current through this R2 resistor? I just circle and circle with the purple color. You just see my answers. So what is the current through the second resistor? The current is 0.8 ampere. And I find out with the help of the basic Ohm's law and basic rule that whenever resistances are in series, equal current flow both from both of them. And when I find out the current, easily by putting the Ohm's law V is equal to IR, I find out the second answer, that what is the voltage, what is the voltage across the resistance, and that is V is equal to 8 volt. V is equal to 8 volt. Okay, so I think you understand my question. Vishal Kumar, if you write down 0.26, I don't know why you write down. Later on, after completing, I will interact with you for the same, why you write down 0.26. Okay. Now I'm going for the third numerical, that is on our next topic, that is of resistivity. Okay. In laboratory, whenever we come in all practicals, then we just put this kind of example. We just put a 5 ohm resistance, a 10 ohm resistance in series, a battery we will use, and we just put a battery across this R1 resistance, or we just put a 4 voltage across it. Then you will see by connecting the multimeter across this 10 ohm resistance, the voltage will be 8 volt. And we will prove that these kind of numerical will exist because of the Ohm's law and the basic rules of resistances which we used. So practically we will also do the same things to find out the answer. Okay, now see the third numerical. Now see this third numerical. Okay. Okay. Let's suppose I have one more numerical. I just remove this numerical. Anyone just take a snapshot and send me in which this screen is visible. Okay, I will take this snapshot. Okay, now see, I'm talking about the new numerical. So see, this is my new numerical, that is on resistivity. Now see, a wire of length with this red color, I am showing you what the parameters in going in this question. A wire of length 3 meter is given. Length is given, it means L is given as 3 meter. Okay. Okay. एंड एरिया ऑफ क्रॉस सेक्शन, एंड एरिया ऑफ क्रॉस सेक्शन इज गिवन एज 1.7 मल्टीप्लाई बाय 10 टू पावर माइनस 6. इट इज नॉट 10 माइनस 6, इट इज 10 टू पावर माइनस 6 मीटर स्क्वायर. ओके, दैट्स फाइन. वी जस्ट पुट दिस वैल्यू 1.7 मल्टीप्लाई बाय 10 टू पावर माइनस 6. 1.7 मल्टीप्लाई बाय 10 टू पावर माइनस 6. ओके, यू जस्ट वेट फॉर अ व्हाइल. Okay, 1.7 into 10 to power minus 6. So cross-sectional area, it means A is given. It means A is given. So A is equal to 1.7 multiply by, so I put a multiply sign there, 10 to power minus 6. 10 to power minus 6. Okay, meter is.
सर आवाज नहीं सुनाई दे रहा है।
आवाज नहीं आ रहा. नहीं आ रहा.
So dear student, due to lights are cut off, I was unable to continue that lecture, and a little bit, a short duration of break was there. Kindly wait, I just reopen this MS Paint file and we just complete our numerical. Okay. Yes. I just open that MS Paint file. Wait for a while. Okay. Now see this MS Paint file. And in the video, whenever you will see this video on YouTube, काइंडली हैव अ पेशेंस, वेन एवर दिस 5 मिनट्स ब्रेक यू विल सी दिस इज ड्यू टू दी लाइट इंटरप्शन. ओके, नाउ सी, अ वायर ऑफ लेंथ 3 मीटर एंड एरिया ऑफ क्रॉस सेक्शनल 1.7 × 10⁻⁶ m² इज गिवन, विच हैज अ रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ 3 × 10⁻²⁰ ओम. ओके, कैलकुलेट द रेजिस्टिविटी ऑफ द वायर. कैलकुलेट, वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट दी रेजिस्टिविटी ऑफ द वायर. सो हाउ वी कैन कैलकुलेट द रेजिस्टिविटी ऑफ द वायर, वी कैन इजीली अंडरस्टैंड. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, व्हाट इज गिवन, जस्ट लुक एट इट. वायर ऑफ लेंथ 3 मीटर इज गिवन, वायर ऑफ लेंथ 3 मीटर इज गिवन, इट मीन्स एल इज इक्वल टू 3 मीटर, इट मीन्स एल इज इक्वल टू 3 मीटर, इट इज गिवन 3, एल इज इक्वल टू 3 मीटर इज गिवन, एल इज इक्वल टू 3 मीटर इज गिवन. ओके, एंड ए क्रॉस सेक्शनल एरिया ऑफ ए इज गिवन, एंड ए क्रॉस सेक्शनल एरिया ए इज गिवन एज 1.7 × 10⁻⁶ मल्टीप्लाई बाय 10⁻⁶ इज गिवन मीटर स्क्वायर. सो आई जस्ट राइट डाउन मीटर स्क्वायर. You understand by the abbreviation M, that is for meter. Okay, and has a resistance, it is given. I taught you about this area of cross sectional. I mentioned this L length, and now a resistance 3 × 10⁻²⁰ ohm is given. Okay, so we know that the resistance is always given as R, which is equal to 3 × 10⁻². 3 × 10⁻²⁰ ohm. I just copy and paste here. Okay, 3 × 10⁻ it is not directly 10 × that is this is actually 10 × 10⁻³ 3 × 10⁻². Okay, oh, it is given, three parameters are given, and the question say you what is the resistivity of the wire. Calculate the resistivity of the wire, and we know from the formula the R is equal to rho L by A. As I taught you, R is equal to rho L by A, where the meaning of rho is resistivity. So I have to find out the resistivity. What is given, just write down. First of all, R. So what is the R? R is given as 3 × 10⁻². So in place of R, I just write down 3 × 10⁻², is equal to rho. So because I have to find out the value of rho, so I just write down the rho as it is. So I just write down the rho as it is. Okay, multiply by, okay, multiply by, so multiply by L by A, multiply by L by A. So what is L? L is given as 3, L is given as 3. So I just write down 3. I just write down here 3. Divide by A. So I just divide and then divide by A. Divide by A. And what is A? A is given as 1.7 × 10⁻⁶. 1.7 × 10⁻⁶. Okay, so it is given, all the parameters are given, we have to find out only the rho, and it is very easy with the help of the basic mathematics to find out the answer. Now the rho will be equal to, see from this green color, this I have to find out the value of this rho. So this 1.7 × 10⁻⁶ will be multiplied by this term and divide by this 3. Okay, R rho is equal to 3 × 10⁻², multiply by 1.7 × 10⁻⁶. So this term, 3 × 10⁻², multiplied by, so multiply by 1.7 × 10⁻⁶. 1.7 × 10⁻⁶. Divided by 3, divided by 3. Okay, so what we will find out, we just see that with this brown color I am teaching you, this 3 to 3 cancel, this 3 to this 3 will be cancel out. Now only 1.7 and 10⁻⁸ will be the answer. We know that whenever multiplication is there, the power will be added to each other. The power will be add to each other. So 1.7, oh, sorry. Conjugate. Now see. The power will be add to each other. So 1.7 multiply by 10 to power 10 to power minus 6 and minus 2, that is minus 8. That is minus 8. So 1.7 into 10 to power of minus 8, and I know the unit, as we prove, ohm meter is the unit of resistivity. So this is the answer of this third question. So there is a little bit interruption of 2 or 3 minutes due to the lights cut off. Otherwise, continuously we do the three numericals, and whatever we I taught you in basic theory about the Ohm's law and the resistivity, we just applied them in those numericals, and in laboratory we will see them practically also. So I think you understand. So now if you have any query, you can you are free to ask me any query. Thank you for watching the video. Kindly like and subscribe the video so that you will get the notification earlier whenever I will make any video. Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much.